Hello viewers, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making very delicious vegetarian recipe, doi potol posto, pointed gourd cooked in yogurt and poppy seeds gravy. This is a quick and simple recipe that tastes divine with hot steaming rice or roti. The recipe is pure Sadvik recipe, that means we will not be using any onion or garlic, still it will be more tastier than any chicken or meat. To make this recipe, what we need, let me show you. We need pointed gourd, which is about 700 gram. It has been washed and rinsed through and cut into big chunky pieces. Though this is doi potol posto, still we will be adding potato, about 500 gram, that has also been washed and cut into big chunky pieces. To temper the oil, we need 1/2 teaspoon whole cumin seeds, 2 whole red chilies and 2 bay leaves. We will cook this recipe in mustard oil. It will give more better flavor. In spice powders, we need 2 1/2 teaspoon of coriander powder, 2 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, about 1 1/2 teaspoon cumin powder and 1/2 teaspoon turmeric powder. To make the gravy, we need poppy seeds paste. I put 2 tablespoons of poppy seeds in a mixer jar and blend it with 6 tablespoons of water. Then we need 5 to 6 tablespoon beaten yogurt. We also need 1 tablespoon ginger paste, 1 tablespoon chili paste, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala. Apart from this, we also need salt, sugar and ghee. They are very common in any vegetarian Bengali recipe. In a karai or pan, add 1 tablespoon of mustard oil. When the oil is smoky hot, add potatoes. Also add salt and turmeric. Mix all together for about 3 to 4 minutes. When the potatoes become little golden brown, take it out. We don't need to make it soften. So I'm taking out in a bowl. Similarly, shallow fry the pointed gourd, add 1 tablespoon of mustard oil. After that, add pointed gourd, add salt and turmeric powder. Mix well and also cook this for 4 to 5 minutes until it becomes light golden brown. We don't need to make it soften. So I'm taking out in a bowl. The pan is sticked with some masala, so I'm going to wipe it out with a clean tissue paper so that the masala that we are going to put in this, that won't burn. Now add remaining mustard oil, about 5 to 6 tablespoons. Let it be hot. Now temper this oil with bay leaves, 2 red chilies. Always break the red chilies and put in the oil, else it will splatter and harm your skin. Then add whole cumin seeds and saute this for about 30 to 40 seconds. When the zira will splatter nicely, ginger paste and red chili paste. Also cook this for about 2 to 3 minutes. When the nice aroma will come out from this ginger and chili paste, add all the spice powder like coriander powder, cumin powder, red chili powder and turmeric powder. I'm going to also be adding little salt. Make sure you don't add too much salt because we already have added salt while cooking potato and pointed gourd. To cook this all masalas, add little bit of water. Is the dry masala will get burned. Now the masalas are nicely cooked and oil separated. So add poppy seeds paste. Also cook it well. After putting poppy seeds paste, it will absorb the oil and will come together. So cook it on medium to low flame until it gets nicely cooked. After that, add yogurt. and also cook it for more 2 to 3 minutes. After putting yogurt, the masala will be separate from the oil, and that's the thing we need to make good gravy. Now all the masala cooked well. Now I'm going to be adding the fried potato and pointed gourd. Mix with all the spices. Also add little bit of sugar to balance the taste. Now cook this on low flame for 5 to 6 minutes by covering the lid. In this time between, the pointed gourd and potato will absorb the flavor from the masala. After cooking for 5 to 6 minutes, put the lid off, just a quick stir, and add 1 or 2 cups of hot water. Now stir well, cover the lid and cook this for another 8 to 10 minutes until the potato and pointed gourd become soft. After 10 to 12 minutes, remove the lid and also check the thickness of the gravy. The gravy will be thick, not so thin. So this is the perfect consistency that I was looking for. So finally add garam masala powder and ghee. Ghee and garam masala at the end of cooking add more flavor. So this delicious doi potol posto is all done. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. It goes well with hot steaming rice or roti. Today I am gonna serve this with hot rice. See the thickness of the gravy. Should definitely try this recipe any day. Once in a week we don't eat any non-veg and onion garlic. So in that day we usually make this dish. Very simple and soothing recipe. So try once and let me know how it came out in the comment section below. Like this video, share this video and subscribe to my channel. We'll see you again. Till then take care and thanks for watching.